Greetings, people of God, and welcome to the Ministry Lab's Minnesota-based Psalm 148 reflection. Thank you to Fish Lake and Trinity of LaPorte Lutheran Churches, to Union Congregational UCC of Hackensack and Plymouth Congregational UCC of Minneapolis, and to Glenwood United Parish, UMC, and UCC for these beautiful images. Thanks also to Julia Bloom from Cabin of Love Music for the brilliant score, and to Melissa Weinhandel for pulling it all together with editing. Psalm 148 is a gorgeous, expansive, creation-centric song assigned for the Sunday we often call the Slaughter of the Innocents. But immersing ourselves in this exuberant praise might be healing and renewing at any time. The glorious cosmic scope of this hymn seems out of context with Herod's agonizing brutality. It might feel out of context with our current personal and global realities too, as we collectively endure a quademic of illness, supremacy-based heteronormative divisiveness and racism, economic instability, and climate change. As each of us plows through our own individual traumas and losses, as war and gun violence, famines, fires, droughts, and bizarre storms, loss of autonomy and land ravage the globe. And the list goes on. Whether reading Matthew's account of the slaughter of the innocents or simply living amidst current realities, how do we who are overflowing with lament and grief, who have been steeped in trauma after trauma, how do we hear creation, which itself continuously endures slaughter? How do we hear creation sing, shout, clap, and cavort, and participate with creation in offering God praise and thanksgiving? 10 days after Rosh Hashanah, the celebratory Jewish New Year, comes the Day of Atonement, the holiest and most solemn day of the year. Yet Yom Kippur is also infused with an undercurrent of joy for the confidence that God will forgive and seal one's future health and happiness. When our grief is infused with guilt, one way to move from trauma to praise is to repent and atone, to acknowledge the guilt of our action or inaction, our contribution to the pain or our lack of providing relief from it, and turn that guilt over to God, trusting divine grace to relieve our burdened souls, as our Jewish siblings do each Yom Kippur. In New Orleans, second-line dancers carry on the funeral traditions of their enslaved ancestors, moving seamlessly from grief into rapturous joy by sharing the grief of death with the whole community. When our grief stems from loss or trauma, we might learn from this sacred practice of sharing our grief across generations and amidst community. Psalm 148 invites us to consider both of these opportunities, releasing the guilt of our culpability into divine grace and sharing our grief with others. And when the grief and trauma is so deep and so broad, when even our community cannot contain it, allowing creation to hold us and restore us, eventually restoring us to thanksgiving and praise. So we share this psalm, rich with images from across the state of Minnesota, in the hopes that it can provide a time away, or at least a time of rest for weary preachers, and in the hopes that it can serve as a container of sorts for our shared experiences of grief and joy, lament and hope, repentance and renewal. As the year turns, as we travel through Epiphany, let these next few moments be for you, your community, and the whole of God's beloved creation surrounding you, a time of respite from the slaughter, a time of reconciliation, a time of rest in the company of all that God has called good. Psalm 148.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Give voice to wonder and awe. Praise from the heavens. Praise from the mountaintops. Praise God, all you angels. Praise God, heavenly chorus. Praise God, sun and moon. Praise God, you morning stars. Praise God, expanding universe. Praise God, flowing galaxies. God. Sing and shout, show off your delight. Let the cosmos praise the wondrous name of Yahweh, who spoke and out they flew, who gave them their places. From the beginning and through eternity, who established their orbits and set them dancing. Name your deep felt gratitude. Praise God from earth. You sea monsters, you fathomless ocean depths. Fire and hail, snow and ice, hurricanes obeying divine orders. Mountains and all hills, apple orchards and cedar forests. Wild beasts and herds of cattle. Snakes and birds in flight. creatures of the earth and all peoples. Government and corporate leaders. Young men and women alike. Elders and children together. Let them praise the holy mystery. The only praiseworthy name we know. For divine glory radiates beyond even earth and sky. God has built a monument. A people. Speak your truth. Express your joy. Praise God, all you faithful. All you who love God. All you beloved children. Praise God.